Steve, any fresh team news, first of all, after the weekend?
Obviously, Wayne and Liam came off the game the other day, so they're touch and go whether they'll be available for Wednesday. So they haven't trained today, but there's another training day tomorrow. So hopefully we can get them out, but we won't take any risks at the same time. Apart from that, yeah, no, we're fine.
It was a really positive day, obviously, on the weekend, wasn't it? And you've got Manchester City to look forward to in the next round. That's one that everyone can get excited about when it comes around, isn't it?
Yeah, when it comes round. Yeah, I can't say I've thought about it too much at the moment. Obviously, we've got championship games to take care of first and foremost. But yeah, when we get them championship games out of the way, we'll look forward to them. We'll get ready for it. But I can't say I've thought about it too much at this moment in time.
Okay, I know you only think about the next one. Mm. Quite a big one, isn't it? Brentford, obviously the team you faced in the playoffs, the team who are up there again alongside you. How big is this game?
It's going to be a tough game, of course. Brentford are a good team and in good form. You know, whatever time of the season that you play, it's always going to be a challenge, but it's one we're looking forward to. It's one we'll definitely be ready for. And, you know, they're in good form. When in good form, you've got the makings of a really good game. But our focus will just be on how we win and how we play well. And we've, you know, been committing to that the last couple of days. And then, yeah, you know, any game at home, we have to really go for. And, you know, Wednesday will be no different. So yeah, you know, it can't come quick enough, really.
Is it important, though, obviously 3 points available every time you step on the pitch, but is it important to strike a blow when you face these clubs who look like being your rivals from now until the end of the season?
Yeah, time will tell on them things. Obviously, you know, there's so many games at the moment where, you know, they're all, as you said, that this is 3 points to gain and that's it. So, you know, if they end up, any of these games end up being pivotal and when looking back, then only we'll know right at the end. So you know, we're living in the moment. We're taking each game as it comes. There's always a different sort of content and context around a game, you know, and we try and deal with it as we face it. So Brentford next at home. Yeah, good one. Good one to look forward to.
Could it be a first sight of Jordan Morris in a Swansea shirt on Wednesday night?
Well, he's definitely available for selection. So if he doesn't start, I'm sure he'll be on the bench. So yeah, maybe, yeah.
We talked a bit about him at the weekend, but is it a case for him that he's competing with Andre Ayew and Jamal Lowe for game time, the way you've set your team up for the vast majority of the season?
Yeah, I think that would be fair to say. Gareth, I think any of the boys not in the starting lineup or in the lineup, they're always fighting to either get into the team or stay in the team. So not just in the strikers positions. I think, you know, we've got, you know, a number of players who can, you know, if they're not starting a game, can play in the next one. So Jordan obviously adds to the strikers options, obviously with Wayne and Liam as well, as well as Andre and Jamal. So I think it's healthy, you know. I think this schedule as well, you know, you're going to need probably more than the normal size core of players, and the more strength and depth that we can have, the better. So competition for places, I think, is a good thing, and we feel like we can have that now in a number of positions.
You touched on how well Brentford are going. 16 unbeaten, I think they are in the league. How good is this Brentford team, do you think?
Yeah, no, it's on the day they can be a good team, but so can we, you know. And I think if you worry too much about the opposition, then you're not focusing on yourselves enough. We respect every opponent the same, you know. We this league particularly can catch you when you're not looking, you know. So there'll be no difference in approach to this game as will be the one before, which was Barnsley, and the one after it, you know. But we respect where we think they have strengths, but equally we will be aware of where we think we can exploit weaknesses as well. So the approach won't change.
Finally, for me, transfer window's nearly closed. Do you anticipate doing much more, or indeed anybody going the opposite direction?
Well, I hope nobody goes out. There may be one or two of the younger lads that we might consider a loan for, But out of the core of the boys have been involved in the first team, then, you know, we certainly don't hope that nobody leaves. Never say never on players coming in. You know, I'll always want something. If something pops up that we think is doable and is right, then, you know, we'll have a go at it. But is there anything imminent? No, there's not. Nothing will happen today or tomorrow. By the end of the window, another week, then who knows?
Is there a position that when you look at your squad, is there anywhere now you think I could do with somebody there? Because you look reasonably well stocked now, whereas, you know, a few weeks ago, maybe there were some obvious holes that needed filling.
I think like standard answer, really, you're always looking to improve if something's there, and you should never settle, you know, for anything less. But I'm happy. I'm always happy with the boys. You know, I'm always happy with the players that are available. You know, the ones when I get a list every morning that's available to train, that's where my focus goes. And that was today, that'll be the same tomorrow. And then we'll try and pick the right team for Wednesday. So if we can add one or two before the end of next week or whenever it is the end of the window, then fine. If not, then we crack on. And what I do hope is that we don't lose anybody. And, you know, I don't really see that happening. So fingers crossed.
Thank you, Steve.
Thanks, Gareth.
All right, let's go next.
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay.
Yeah, there seems to be a real buzz about not just the way you're playing, but, you know, the atmosphere. How important is that going into, you know, a schedule like it is, and how excited are you for tomorrow?
There is a buzz. There's a real buzz in the training ground. Players and staff are really, really getting on well with each other, but at the same time, very focused and determined to keep striving to improve. And I think that's, you know, it's really important. And when you have that, that, you know, you recognise it, and players really living the moment, and the staff, and that's what we're trying to do. So, you know, it's my job to make sure that we keep building on that, and we don't take any backward steps, and we don't let complacency kick in. And I think, you know, that's what a high performing culture is. You know, it's always been our aim, and that will never change. So, everyone's really enjoying their work at the moment, you know, and, you know, long may it continue.
Yeah, and I'm giving tomorrow night at home, obviously there's no crowd, but it'd be a good one, wouldn't it?
It should be, yeah. I mean, Wednesday, not tomorrow. Yeah,
sorry,
I was thinking that. So I had a panic up then. Yeah, no, listen, any game at the Liberty is a good one, and there's lots of games that we've played or going to play, but I thought, it'd be brilliant if the supporters were here today, both home and, you know, and away. But it's not to be at the moment, and we've always got to bear in mind that they're not with us, and we have to do as best we can to keep them as pleased as possible, albeit from home. So, yeah, I mean, it doesn't seem like there's not even any talk at the moment, is there, of fans returning, and, you know, it's you know, it's been long-winded, isn't it, the lockdown, and it's really sort of taking its toll, I know, for a lot of people. So I'm constantly reminding the players and supporters, the players and staff, that who we're doing it for, and, you know, they're not all as fortunate as us. And I generally think the players are aware of that and care about it. So you know, Wednesday's the next time to try and put a good performance on and win a game, and we're going to go for it.
Last question from me. You know, we've talked over the last few weeks about momentum, and you have that certainly. How difficult is it to balance the team with bringing new players in and not upsetting the apple cart? You know what some players can be like, you know, egotistically. They look around their shoulder and think, oh, is he going to take my place?
Yeah, that's how it is, isn't it? You know, everybody wants to play, you know, everybody, you know, wants to be in the next lineup. We get that, I think this year, because of the schedule and because we sort of sometimes in the busy times have taken the approach of making some changes, I think it's kept everybody engaged and everybody focused. And, I think I'm really lucky with the dressing room that I have. I think the players, you know, led by the older ones are, you know, team first and themselves second. And I think that's a really important way to be. And I think if anybody tries and behaves not that way, it stands out like a sore thumb. And you know, I think, you know, I recognise that with the players, they recognise it themselves, and everyone's committed to to the greater good. You know, I'm not asking people to be pleased if they're not selected, but at the same time, you know, they don't let any frustrations or any disappointment interfere with the greater good. So, and for me, that's a sign of a really good culture, you know, because not accepting not being in the team, but at the same time, not let it get in the way of the progression and the performance of the next game. And that's what I think we have at the moment.
Yeah, and I think people don't recognise how hard that is to get. But on that note, when you bring players in, do you think about their personality as well as their on-pitch?
To be honest, as much, because, you know, they wouldn't be in the reckoning if they weren't the right footballer. And a lot of my focus then goes on the type of person that they are and whether they could fit into what, you know, what I just explained about being the right culture. So I think, yeah, Beth, I think it's sort of doubly important that you bring the right characters in. And I've said all along, you know, we're not just going to collect good players. We're going to select the right ones. And then once we do that, hoping that we can get them over the line. I look at Conor Hourihan, and or everyone knows he's a really good player and, you know, he's a well-known player, you know, to the Premier League and also the Championship. But, you know, but he's definitely the right person to bring in as well. He's the right character. You know, he's really trying to buy into, you know, how we work here. And, you know, that's the type of scenario we want to have when we bring new players in.
Brilliant. And good luck for Wednesday.
Thanks, Beth.
Steve, with someone like Conor coming in, is that a psychological boost to the group as well? You've got a player coming from Premier League background and, you know, with experience. They can see that there's a bit of ambition from the club and you've got a bit more quality to work with.
I hope so. I think that's the best scenario, isn't it, when bringing new players in, that people see it as a positive move and they're going to help the team, help the squad, and not see it as a threat or, people are not being selfish. And I don't, that's not the case. As I said, everyone knows Conor's a really, really good player. And I think, like I just said there, everyone knows he's committed to what we and the football club are trying to do, because, you know, we don't work as individuals, we work as a group. So, and the same with Jordan as well. You know, Jordan Morris has got a great pedigree, international player, you know, numerous caps and, you know, MLS winner. So, so you know, he comes with great pedigree as well. So, you know, Ben Hamer, similar, you know, experienced, you know, knows what it takes to be in a successful team dressing room. And yeah, you know, it's I think the boys who are already here are welcoming the new players in, knowing that it's going to help us.
From the outside, it looks as though you're really serious. I mean, everyone's serious, but you're really making steps towards pushing to get back into the Premier League. And these 10 days with two games against your top rivals, there's a chance to make a real statement.
There's only 3 points from any of these games. So, you know, we treat every game equally. You know, like Gareth asked me before, you it's not until we look back at the end of the season whether certain games are going to end up being more pivotal than others, and now they go. So we're all season, we've talked about one game at a time, live in the moment, get ready for the next game, put the last one to bed, whatever's happened, win, lose or draw, and see what it takes us in the end. And you know, we're going into another, you know, another busy period in February, and you know, before we know it, there'll be another load of games we've just played. So, you know, just look for the next one and get ready for it.
And how much better do you think your Swansea City side is now than when you played Brentford in the playoffs?
Again, I think it's one of them that now is not the time to compare. You know, there's no value in that. I don't see the point in thinking about them things. I think it's last season's been and gone. Neither team got promoted, you know. We both got to the playoffs and that was that. You know, there was no success stories from it. And it seems like an age ago. So, yeah, I mean, I'm only looking forward, Rob. I'm looking forward to see how we progress and get to the levels that I want us to get to. And there's a long way to go. But we're committed to it, and I'm confident that we can reach them.
Okay, finally then, you must have been pleased to see 5 goals go in.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, it could be be okay if we could do that a bit more. But and good goals as well. You know, I think is, you know, straight off how we play model, and good finishes, good creative play, team in good position, playing together as a team. And good to see some of the younger boys, you know, get the final touch as well. So it's gone now, you know, and of course a lot of good things came out of that game, and a lot of confidence and momentum, et cetera, et cetera. But it's in the past now, and everything's now focused on the next one.
Well, we're hungry for more. Hopefully you can deliver on Wednesday.
Yeah, hopefully, Rob.
Thanks.
See you, mate.
Steve, you said about guarding against complacency. I mean, you won 6 out of 7, one draw. How does a manager actually do that? How do you smell complacency? How do you stamp down on it quickly when you see it?
Well, I think you have to go, like you said, a little bit off smell, a bit off instinct on what you might be feeling on any given day. And I don't feel it today, that's for sure. And I don't think I will tomorrow either, because I know how hungry these boys are. And sometimes, you know, you can be in the best shape, you can be in the best mindset and lose a game, not play well, you know. But I'd be amazed if complacency or lack of focus or lack of commitment ever creeps into this group. You know, they are so professional, they are so committed, and as well as, you know, trying to play an attractive game of football, they're fighters as well. You know, they really want to stand up for the football club and stand up for each other and give the best they can be. So you know, I don't worry too much about complacency and things like that. You know, like I said, the signs are good. We're in the training room, so the training ground so vibrant. You can see the players are enjoying their work, but you can see a real sort of focus in their eyes as well, a real strong mentality in keeping things going. And like I said, you've got to grab hold of that and put it to best use, and that's what we're trying to do.
Are you surprised at how quickly a lot of the younger players have matured over the last few months?
Yes and no. Because you should never take anything for granted with these young ones, and it's sometimes a rocky road to get to become established, as I know I've talked about on numerous occasions. But they're super talented, the young ones, and what they are, as much as talent, and is what, and you need both, is they are so committed to being the best they can be. You know, they focus on not the glitz and glamour of being a footballer. They focus on performance and how they keep improving, how they, you know, they raise the bar as an individual, and you know, that's what young players need to be. You know, because in the end, that takes you to the best of your potential. So yeah, you know, every day these young boys that are with us, even the ones that are just on the fringes of the squad who have come up from the 23s, you know, they are so committed. They'll all be downstairs now working in the gym, working on their video analysis. You know, there's no shortcuts for these lads. They really are going for it. But that's because the older players are the same, you know, and they got some great role models and are seeing it at its best. And in the end, you know, you get what you deserve, don't you? So, pleased with the young boys. But as always, it's about keeping going and striving to get better.